This is how chaotic the situation has been at the opposition's FDC headquarters at Najjanankumbi in Kampala. Pelting stones and beating up party members was witnessed as a group of youth tried to block some members from accessing the party premises to attend the National Council meeting.
If police looks on and people move from inside and come and beat people outside, and then you just let them go, it would not be right. Unless you want us also to be violent.
Have I pushed you?
We are not violent, we are just looking on.
The situation worsened when the aggrieved members, who were armed with stones and sticks, started banging the party gate, something which led to a fight.
They want people to beat us. They are the one who are saying that they are the one who are saying that they want National Council. National Council is here. And then they are trying to bring the first to disrupt the National Council. What is their purpose?
Do not support Yagun. If you do not support Yagun, they will send people to abuse you.
You were good.
And they will send people to slap you.
Let me tell you.
They will send people to beat you up.
Leadership will never abuse
but
you.
But we are not going to be intimidated.
Who is intimidating you?
No one is
blackmailing you. No one is black. And you also can't blackmail us. You can't
so these are some of the people.
These are some of the people who are ungrateful. You need to look at yourself. Look at yourself in the mirror. Because
you are a liar.
You don't come for neck meetings and then you are all over the news. When did you ever last come for neck meetings?
This forced police to heavily deploy and also disperse the two groups which were fighting. In this scuffle, some arrests were made. The FDC security team accused some of the party leaders, including Ssemujju Nganda, for sending goons at the party premises to disrupt the National Council meeting. At around 11 a.m., the deputy president of FDC in Buganda, Erias Lukwago, arrived for the meeting. He was, however, denied entry at the gate and instructed not to get in with his vehicle, something which angered him, and he decided to boycott the meeting.
It's on tenterhooks. It's tension all over. And this, which expectations now? They have blocked my vehicle from entering here. I have to enter with my vehicle here. I have to access the premises. I'm not a persona non grata at the FDC. I am a bona fide member. I am the deputy president of the party. And we are here to deliberate on the state of affairs of the party. We have a report which is supposed to be given. Unfortunately, the reports we are getting, which are credible, it has been in possession of their chosen person, the Honorable Nanda, the Honorable Patrick Oboya Muriat. They are the ones in possession of the same. Actually, for over 2 weeks, they have been in possession of this report. It's already doctored, and they just want to use this kind of kangaroo methods of sailing through with that process.
Allegations of the plot to sell FDC to the ruling NRM party after some top party leaders allegedly received money from NRM has been the cause of the worsening internal wrangles within the FDC party. However, these wrangles leave the party's future uncertain. Report compiled by Jaliat Namuwaya for the news.